Ladies and gentlemen, this is our next PGN election. This debate is hosted by none other than Jack Lamb from LNN News Corporation. We'd like to give a big round of applause to Mr.
We
Jack
can't
Lamb.
See you.
Yes, you can't. Well, you can't see me? Shit.
No.
Why not?
Too much smoke.
Anyway, this is brought to you by LNN Lamb News Network. This is brought to you by Redwood Cigarettes. Thank you, Redwood Cigarettes, for sponsoring this debate. Now, this is the biggest election we've ever had. We're going to have 2 cents just so we can get it down to a 1v1. If you thought Lamb versus Long was intense, this is going to be the best night of your life. Mr. Lamb, please introduce us to these brand new candidates.
Come on out, Daddy.
Thank you very much. Well, first of all, good evening, everyone. From the Maze Bank Arena, I'm Jack Lamb, owner of the Lamb News Network, and I welcome you to the first debates of the Summer 2023 gubernatorial election. This event is broadcasted by the Lamb News Network, the last major news company that still holds truth at its core. Before we begin, I would like to announce the Bean Machine as our very first Los Santos Business of the Week. The Bean Machine owners will receive a $25,000 grant to invest back into their business and continue to provide their customers with an amazing experience. Now for tonight's debate. I have designed the formats. First, opening statements followed by individual questions from the moderator. That's me. Then we will have a bullet round followed by candidate duels. I'll explain what that is later. Lastly, if we have time, we will end with questions from the audience and closing statements. We request that the audience here in this arena remain silent while the candidates are speaking. No cheers, no boos, or other interruptions so that we, and more importantly, you, can focus on what the candidates have to say. No noise except right now as we welcome the candidates one by one. First, Cornelius Higglebottom.
Let's go!
Rocky Goat. Next, Johnny News.
Yeah.
Hey, Cornelius. Hey, Cornelius.
Hello.
What's up, chumps?
Up next, Pete Mitchell.
Yeah,
let's
that's
go,
me.
Pete.
Thanks, man.
Cornelius right, sits on a throne of lies.
Boss.
Oh, yes. The Jack Lamb podcast theme, I hear.
Damn, Julian, sorry we're safe.
Up next, Mr. James Petrov. Is James Petrov here?
He couldn't make it.
All right.
Just a second.
Moving on. Sabrina Palpatine.
Appreciate it, my sir.
Up next, I don't think Kanye West is here, is he? Don't think so. All right, up next we have Dundreary Regina.
Woo.
Welcome.
Dundreary.
Dundreary.
Regina.
And lastly, our final candidate to welcome up on stage, Ugg.
Ugg.
Yeah. Yeah, oh god! Yeah,
oh god! Wonderful.
AMP ugly.
All right. We can cut the song now, and Candidates, feel free to move a little bit more that way just so you're more centered out.
Oh, yeah.
I don't want the people on the left of the theater to not see you as much as the people on the right of the theater. All right. Wonderful. All right. Welcome, candidates. We will begin with a 30-second introductory statement from all of you. When you hear this sound, it means your time is up and you must stop speaking. All right. We'll go in the same order of your introductions. Mr. Cornelius Higglebottom, your 30-second introductory statements begins now.
All right, people, look, you already know me. I don't need to introduce myself, okay? What I will say is I've enjoyed being your governor. You know, this is my very first time actually doing the politics. It's been very fun, okay? I've not only been on very day, I've been the most active governor San Andreas has ever seen, and I plan to keep it that way for the second term, okay?
I don't know about that.
He's almost right.
But all I'm saying is you guys should vote for me, okay? I'm going to prove these jokers wrong, so I got to say for now.
Thank you.
Cornelius.
Thank you very much. Next, Mr. Rocky Goats, if he's here. Where's Rocky?
Yeah, Rocky! Oh, he's not here. This is awkward.
Is he not here?
Represent.
All right, we will skip Mr. Rocky Goats. Next, 30-second introductory statement from Mr. Johnny News.
Hello, I'm Johnny News, reporter and CEO for the Big Sport Daily. I'm the only one here tonight who isn't here for the power, but rather the people of San Andreas. I believe the DJ is corrupt and should be restructured for the people, because that's what matters, not what Jack Lamb tells you in Lamb News. They lie to you, they twist the media, and they're holding a lot of power. We gotta remove that. I will bomb the Lamb News HQ if I win.
I guess.
I will call in an
airplane. I like his moxie.
What? Fake news!
All right. Yeah, that's...
I'm not a lizard, I'm a human!
That's enough of that. All right.
I'm not an alien.
Next, 30 seconds from Pete Mitchell.
Put me down. Let's go, Pete. Thank you. My name's Pete Mitchell. Yeah, I'm the most erotic man in the world. Currently in production of Sex 3. If you want a cameo, just hit me up. I plan to make the state very good. I'm constipated. Yeah, I love you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mitchell.
Little Rockins. Pookie Bear.
Up next... I do not believe Mr. Petrov is here. So, Mr. Lumen, I believe Mr. Petrov wanted Phantom Skull to be his representative today. Is that acceptable?
You know what? Screw it. Go for it.
All right.
Pack it in.
Mr. Phantom Skull, go ahead and give Mr. James Petrov's introductory statement starting now.
Okay, so James is very sorry that he couldn't make it, but he's a great person. He's the owner of Petrov's Pieces, one of the finest gun stores in San Andreas. He has a very good plan to help San Andreas that I did not actually listen to, but I'm sure it's very good. I'm just going to be winging half of this, but he's a very good person. So
that Phantom Skull guy's got my vote.
Thank you very much.
Friend.
Yes, Phantom Skull, you got my vote!
Up next,
hey, Mr.
Sabrina
Lance,
Palpatine. You have 30 seconds.
This is going to sound weird, but here we go. As time of is a dedicated servant of progress and civility, our state deserves a leader who understands the balance between order and freedom, prosperity and security. For my career, I've powerfully worked to empower communities and forfeit. Words are hard. Ensure bright futures. As your potential governor,
Gutterball.
What am I listening to right now?
Most of those words I don't even understand.
I heard three of those words, but we give you a round of applause for effort. Good job.
No round of applause.
All right. Next, Mr. Dundry Regina.
I think we scared her off.
Look at this guy, ChatGPT.
He's a robot.
Hello, I am Dundry Regina, and I believe 9/11 was bad. Guns are a human right.
Can you just make a Family Guy reference?
And personality is king. That is all.
This guy has no personality.
Imagine voting for that guy.
All right.
Loser.
Vote for him.
And Lastly, please welcome an opening statement from Ugg Ugg.
You kind of sound like an alien.
Yeah! Yeah! Ugg Ugg!
Yeah! Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yes,
I like drugs and meth. And well for Cornelius. And that drug.
What?
That's my governor right there, baby!
Thank
yeah.
you. Thank you very much.
Did he just say vote for Cornelius?
Is that a human hand?
Oh yeah, I bought it from the morgue.
I thought he just said vote for Cornelius.
Wait, you bought it from the morgue?
Did you just say vote for Cornelius?
Okay.
I think that's what he said.
Reverse psychology, classic Ugg Ugg.
Whoa.
Moving on. I will ask each of these candidates who showed up today an individual question that I personally wrote. They did not have access to these questions, so this will be the first time they're hearing them. We will begin in the same order, starting with Mr. Cornelius Higglebottom.
You.
Cornelius, come up on the front, Cornelius. Also, you'll have 30 seconds to provide an answer for
just a heads up, my head is really bad right now, and it might head pop, so.
All right, no problem.
Some governor you are.
Got them all. It's not my fault, I got a potato head, okay?
All right, Cornelius. You are the current governor running for a second term.
Murder Rocky.
You are also probably the favorite in this election based on our polling. Your supporters will say that that's because of your performance while in office. But some might criticize your choice to run again for a second term because you already had your time as governor. And if you were an effective governor, you would have already gotten done everything you promised to do. How do you respond?
I don't know. He helped me make content. It was all right.
The funny thing is all the goals that I stated during my election, my election season, I actually already, completed. I helped SecureServe with their gun laws, you with your journalist laws. I've helped make DNR their own very department.
You have the business, but not the people!
Julian, shut up!
Please no interruptions from the audience, thank you.
Okay, and, people might be asking me why I'm running for a second term. Same reason why Meek ran for a second term, he wants to help the people,
Rest in peace, Meek.
I'm not doing
rest
this for
peace.
Myself, but yes, rest in peace, Meek. He was the best governor.
All right. Thank you very much, Cornelius. Up next.
Oh my god, that's Rocky Goat!
Shit, you lie!
Again.
Oh my god, is that Rocky Goat on the stage?
Is Mr. Rocky Goat here?
Oh my god, it's Rocky Goat.
Is he here?
Oh good, you made it. There he is, right there!
Mr. Goats.
I'm here.
Mr. Goats, welcome to the arena. I'll ask you your question now, Mr. Rocky Goats. Ram News recently reported that you went to Ram Ranch and attempted to blind several bystanders with your flashlight. Now, Ram News is a fraudulent news organization that has been proven in court to defame people, so this is likely a fake story. But, given Ram News' status as a fake news organization, why did you think it was a good idea to even visit Ram Ranch in the first place?
Hold on a minute. Objection, Mr. Lamb. Mr. Lamb, isn't it true that in head you spent over $700 on a flashlight?
What I do in head and out of head is irrelevant to this question now, Rocky Goats. Please.
I love you, Rocky.
You chose to visit Ram Ranch, and are these the types of decisions citizens can expect you will make as governor?
Absolutely not. We're going to be making the funding better for law enforcement and getting rid of fake news companies like this Ram News.
PCSO.
That's what I'm saying.
Well, get rid of Big Sport Daily.
I personally, I like Ram News personally. I would say
Ram News down with dump.
Please, no interruptions from the audience. Thank you. Please proceed.
All Rocky Go does is transfer departments.
That was it. That was
is there any other questions?
No, that was your individual question. Thank you, sir. Thank you. All right. Up next, Johnny News. Please come up front for your question.
Me?
Yes, Johnny News. Johnny News, similar question. You are most famous for your news network, Big Sport Daily, which frequently publishes fake stories and defamatory information
about the
citizens of San Andreas. Citizens like Chief Julian Specht and me, Jack Lamb. Is it or is it not your strategy to lie to the people of San Andreas, hoping that they trust you and put you in power? Or is it your plan to admit to your lies and run an honest campaign from here on out?
So you're saying I put out fake news stories and you gave me a rigged question? There's no way I can answer this question great.
That was an unbiased question.
Last time I checked, that
I've been blocked by Lamb News multiple times for entering news sites. I've been blocked multiple times for he covered up the fire. He covered up the fire on his house. He did it for insurance fraud.
This is what I love to see.
There's videos saying that he's an alien. He is alien. I've talked to the guy who sells him babies that he consumes.
Okay.
This is all true information. All
right. Yeah, all right. Time is up. Time is up.
All
right, Mr. Johnny News, please return to your spot. Please,
Mr. Lamb,
please.
I gotta say, Mr. Lamb, he was kind of spitting facts right there. You do eat babies. The newspaper says
okay,
so.
All right. I would like to make it very clear. We are currently in a lawsuit against Ram News for defamation. I do not eat babies. They started this rumor, and they will face me in court for starting that defamatory rumor. Moving on. Is Mr. Pete Mitchell here?
You are not in the election, therefore your opinion.
All right, Mr. Pete, come up front.
Somebody beat this guy to death.
Yeah, I got this.
Welcome, Mr. Mitchell. Sir, you have seemingly come out of nowhere this election, having had no experience in public life. You have spent an exorbitant amount of money advertising what you call the Erotican Party. Critics have described this party as a little bit of a cult. How do you respond?
Let me tell you right now, it's not a cult. It's just a group of us trying to improve the quality of the state of San Andreas. We believe our name, the Erotikans, spreads a powerful message. If you know what I mean.
I got a question for you, actually.
We don't know what you mean.
Go ahead.
So basically, right, you say you're working on the development of Sex 3?
Yes.
So tell me, why is it that for some reason you're able to make Sex 3, yet Sex 2 hasn't even been released yet? Answers, or is it just a lie?
A felony.
Sex 2 got cancelled.
Gutterball.
Oh, really? Did it?
Yes.
Because
yes,
according to my information, we're still in full development, and it'll be here next year, people. I swear, we're working hard on it.
haven't you asked for that development, like, for
we can make
so
it happen
long.
Right now.
We are working, we're working hard, and you're just making up
sex
baseless
three.
Lies saying that
sex
you have Sex 3.
Sex 3 has
you
a
don't
trailer.
Even know what Sex 1 is.
I'll show you sex.
All right, so I feel like we should move on now. Thank you very much, Mr. Mitchell. Your time is up.
Can I quickly say something, though?
Just,
Let him have it.
All right, one sentence,
whoever
please.
Whoever said they'd show me sex, could you please send a message to 077-696-5.
All right, okay, all right. Thank you, Mr. Mitchell. Thank you.
Full Erotikins!
All right, up next, Mr. James Petrov, here being represented by Phantom Skull.
Let's go, Phantom Skull!
I've got his campaign notes. We're good.
Okay, good. Well, I'll just read this as if he was actually here. Mr. Petrov, you are the owner of Petrov's Pieces, the popular gun store here in Los Santos. You have supplied our citizens with guns that you sell, but at the same time, you have also sold weapons to people who have turned out to be criminals. Criminals who used your guns to commit sometimes atrocious acts of violence and terrorism. What do you say to people who blame you for the crime in our state?
Okay, well, for one thing, I warned him not to sell to the Vincentis, but he didn't listen to me on that one, so he's got to take a note on that. But anyways, yeah, okay, James understands that almost all of his sales are 100% legal. He can't really control people doing illegal things with his guns if everything checks out. But he's not going to restrict firearms, despite that, because he's a strong believer in the Second Amendment and thinks there needs to be more guns for people. He just thinks there should be stricter punishments for if you commit illegal acts with them. And, you know, that's his big stand.
Almost all of them are legal.
All right, thank you very much.
Not the gun, not the person.
Did he almost?
Up next, Sabrina Palpatine. Sabrina, if you're here, come on up. All right. Sabrina, you have previously indicated that as governor, you will provide state funding to Ram News. There's also a recent rumor that as governor, you plan to shut down my news network and arrest me personally. I'll now give you a chance to explain whether or not this is true, and also what your policy is regarding the news in San Andreas.
Well, about Ram News being government funded, yes. Just the fact that they're not scared to actually tell the truth, and they've been good on resources. Also, the thing about Ram News, no, that is not true. I have no intention to destroy your building at my proposal. And my thoughts on news is I don't care. I just want real stuff.
I got a question for you, Sabrina. This is the big leagues. We've seen you run off the stage because you got scared. This is the big leagues. You are amongst some of the best in the state who think they have what it takes to be up here and be the governor. And you ran off scared. This is the big leagues, Sabrina. How do we know we can trust you as governor if you're scared of the people?
Because as governor, I would have a clone army.
She's a liberal.
You know what? That is true. That is true. You would have an army.
Yes,
I will.
So you wanna throw the army against the citizens of San Andreas?
All right. Move on. Moving on. Dundry, Regina, please come up. Dundry. Dundry, given your cold and robotic demeanor, many of your critics have indicated that you might not actually be a human and therefore are ineligible to run for governor. So let me just ask you frankly, are you a human, and how do you respond to these critics?
Affirmative. Why I do talk in a robotic tone, it does put me at a disadvantage. Luckily, I still have more personality than half the people here.
He's a Skynet set him. He's gonna kill himself. He's gonna kill himself.
I got two questions for you. Question number one, ain't you a car?
Negative. I am.
All right. Question number two, name the entire cast of Lego Ninjago.
That would be.
Sucks to suck, dude. You're too slow.
Kai, Jay, Nia.
Dang, he did it.
Lloyd.
Very good.
All right. Not bad. Not bad. All right. I give him the points.
All right. Thank you, sir. That is your time. Up
the you got me there. I'm gonna lie.
Last candidates. Algug, please coming up. Algug, can you hear me? Oh yes.
Algug.
All right.
Oh my God,
for your 30-second answer, Algug, you have a lot of supporters, but out of all the candidates here, it appears that you also have the most amount of haters. You receive an immense amount of death threats,
like me.
Both because of your appearance and how you conduct yourself, which critics say is strange and reckless. What do you think about these
like
threats
me.
Against you, and how do you respond to your critics?
If you hate me, catch me outside. I'll shoot your edge.
He's a felon.
He's a known felon. He's a known felon.
Yeah. Oh, God,
we love felons. We love felons.
Oh, God, as the president, I'll take away all your felonies.
Are you seeing no felonies on him?
As law enforcement, I'll give you permission.
God damn it.
Did he just fire a real...
I'm gonna be corrupt!
Can you put that gun down?
No, I don't care. I'm friends with the governor.
Disqualify him!
Oh my God.
Alright. Thank you, Algug. Thank you.
Seems Algug has the intelligence of his followers.
Alright.
Yes, sir! Geniuses!
Up next, we have the bullet round. These are very simple, one-word answers. I'm going to ask you a question, and then we're going to go down the line, and you give me your best one-word answer. First, what will be your number one priority as governor? For your answer, just use, like, either one word or one phrase, something like crime or, like, clean energy, foreign policy, just one...
Those are two words, Lambert.
One phrase is acceptable for this one. So, we'll go down the same order. Cornelius.
Safety, I guess. Yeah.
Safety, I guess. Johnny News.
The people.
The people, okay.
I didn't listen to the question.
Thank you. Okay, Mr. Mitchell?
Oh, well.
Okay. Mr. Mitchell, who is that man you are carrying, and must he be here?
Yes, he must be here. Me, he's
I think
Moy.
Okay.
I love him.
The man who carries you. Yeah. Yes, please give your answer.
Life is Roblox.
Boring on debate.
Okay. What?
Oh my God, what level are you?
Excuse me, what is that music?
Oh, sorry.
Oh, okay, no. Up next, Mr. Petrov.
Bald on the stage.
Okay, he had a note for this one. His one word was... secede from the U.S. What the fuck,
ooh,
Jake?
That's kind of base.
Oh. Well, all right. Sabrina Palpatine.
Boo. Boo.
Sabrina, your number one priority.
Sabrina!
Shooter.
Got scared of the theater.
Slow.
Do it, Ogog, executor.
Yeah,
active governor right here.
All right, Sabrina cannot speak. Dundry Regina.
Nine. 11.
What?
He's okay. A terrorist.
God damn it.
Okay, and lastly, Ogog.
What? Oh.
What?
Taste trap get clapped.
Yeah! Okay, thank you.
Yeah!
Bias. Sabrina, you've told me you can now. Sabrina, give your answer.
Freedom.
Freedom. All right.
No one cares.
Solid. Up next, what one word best describes your feeling about the current governor of San Andreas, Cornelius Higglebottom? We'll go in the same order. Actually, let's go in reverse this time. Starting with Ogog.
You forgot me.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, Rocky. I deleted you because you weren't here. Rocky, what's your number one priority?
Funding.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you. Sorry about that, Rocky. All right. Anyway, one word that describes your feeling about the current governor of San Andreas. Ogog, go ahead.
All right. Gangster.
Gangster. Okay. Dundry. Regina.
On God. What's good, guys?
He's a dollar store. Ogog.
Okay. Sabrina Palpatine.
Pothead.
Oh, all right. James Petrov.
Keeps his promises.
Okay. Pete Mitchell.
Communist.
Rocky Goats.
Joe Biden.
chocolate chip.
Johnny News.
Chocolate chip. Are we talking about our current governor, Higglebottom?
Yes.
Useless. Very useless.
Okay, and lastly, Cornelius Higglebottom.
Yeah, I'd describe myself as fun. I mean, I know I'd have fun.
Fun, okay.
He only knows how to throw parties, not actually do anything.
Johnny, this is...
Why don't you give some funding to some departments?
This is not your time, Mr. News, thank you. Okay. Let's see. Alright, we'll do one more. If you do not win... If you lose, which of the other candidates do you believe would be the worst choice? Who do you least want to become governor? Would be the most dangerous for the people of San Andreas? We'll start with Cornelius Higglebottom.
That's a good one. Probably this big sport news guy. I mean, everything he says is irrelevant and fake. Can't listen. If he can't even listen to the other question that you asked, how is he supposed to listen to the people, you know?
All right. Yes. Okay. Johnny News.
Repeat the question. That was on my phone.
God.
Did Higglebottom make a point?
My point?
Johnny News, which of these do you least want to become governor?
Oh,
which
yeah,
candidates?
Higglebottom.
Okay.
Sir, I couldn't hear your previous question. I only listened to the people of this state.
All right. All right. All right. Move it on.
Oh,
move it on.
Not a baby
I don't know,
eater.
I might be changing sides.
God. Oh, Mr. Lumen.
He may be spitting, but he's not spitting fast.
Rocky Goats.
I'm sorry, what?
That's my governor.
Rocky
Does
Goats.
Have the
oh, yeah, all these guys are idiots. I don't know, I wouldn't vote for any of them.
All right.
What about Ogog?
No, that guy's a felon.
I'm gonna fucking kill you.
Irrelevant.
Next.
Crush his skull.
Mr. Pete Mitchell.
Real quick, mods, can somebody crush this guy's skull right here? He's touching my feet.
Affirmative.
Next.
Mr. Mitchell, please say your answer.
Sabrina,
okay. Yeah. Mr. Petrov.
I got one down here. It would be Johnny News, because this guy is highly irresponsible and just accuses everyone of being...
And we said one word. We said one word.
Thank you, thank you. Sabrina.
Ogog,
okay. Dundry.
Jack Lamb.
But, okay, I'm not a candidate, sir. Out of the candidates.
Tor, you visit the momatorium at the hospital so much. They are renaming it the lamb news buffet. What? Because you eat babies.
All right. Okay. Okay, moving on.
I would kill him.
God. Ugg.
What? Wait, I want to jump. What?
Who do you least want to become governor out of the candidates?
Let's go!
Say that again.
This one right here. This one.
Sabrina, okay.
Point the gun at her to know who it is.
No. Do not do that. All right. And actually, last question of the bullet round. This one you don't have to speak. Simply raise your hand if you agree with this statement. And it is. I can swear tonight that if I lose this election, I will not lead a revolution against the state. If you agree with this statement and you pledge not to lead a revolution against the state if you lose, please raise your hands now.
Remember, this is not required.
No promises.
Oh my God.
That's what I like to see. That's what I like to see.
All right, Cornelius's hands. Phantom is saying that Petrov won't. Ugg, in theory, has a hand in the air, but I'm not sure that's exactly what he's intending.
Rocky, you work for the state. No. Don't worry. I won't. I will.
Oh, okay. Dear Lord, the majority of the candidates right, don't Lamb, make that pledge. Okay.
I think there's only one thing left to do.
What's that?
Boxing fight?
Dog shit!
Ladies and gentlemen, this election has been not according to plan. It's been kind of boring. So here's what we're gonna do.
MMA?
We are gonna see which of these guys has what it takes to throw down in the ultimate caged arena!
Oh,
no.
Yeah! Let him bug shape!
Can I say something?
Title. We need to run.
I would like to say something.
Alright! Everyone out of the circle!
I can't even see it. What in the world?
Yeah!
Alright, Lamb.
Rocky, use your sheriff office steroids.
All right, I'm getting out of here.
So wait, is this a free-for-all or is it one-on-one?
This is a free-for-all.
Oh, boy.
When the bell rings, or when I say go, you are free to start smacking about. Now, hold on.
Is it legal to hit the lady? Come on, Tony. Feel that eroticness in your veins.
Thank you. Oh, God. You know what's up?
I think you should rephrase that.
I was promised a hot guy in a bikini.
Hey,
also,
you know what's up?
Audience, if you want to bet on who you think will win, go to the Lab News Network website and go to our betting sites and place your bets now.
Fuck you.
Are you ready, ladies and gentlemen?
Who's winning?
No.
No.
Candidates! Ready!
Don't worry, I'm here to protect you.
Get the Higgle Bottom!
Throw down! Oh. Yeah!
Me, Pazley! Use brass knuckles! Use brass knuckles!
I'm sorry.
Jumper!
I'm sorry.
Jumper!
Kill that person, motherfucker!
Kill Johnny News!
Kill that big motherfucker!
Sabrina Palpatine on the ground!
Oh my God, I can see it now!
Johnny News running around aimlessly! Rocky Goat swings! Rocky Goat takes Johnny out!
Who's gonna win?
Yes, sir! That'd be really
important! You bought a kins!
This was a clear sweep! He is taking it!
I smell powerless!
Congratulations, Dundry Regina!
Vote for the Erotikins.
What do you have to say to the people?
Fists are mightier than words. And I have proven I am
Nobody's
better.
Voting for that guy.
Shut the fuck up.
Now this is what we came here for! He may not win, or maybe he will! But regardless if he wins this election or not, he proved that he had what it took to face down in the MMA arena! Lamb!
Excuse me.
I think it's time to send this place off!
Lumen, quite frankly, I'm worried about the health of all the other candidates. They're all still on the ground unresponsive.
Bikini.
Lumen!
Hey, you! Come on.
I asked twice, three times.
Lumen, I can't hear you.
You're terrible.
Huh? I can't hear you. You're good now? No, you were. Just at the very... Anyway, we sending this off?
Yes, send this off.
All right.
Vote for the Erotican Party.
Ladies and gentlemen, this has been the first debates of the summer 2023 election. You've met your candidates. And now it's up to you. In 1 week, we will have our first election. After which there will only be two candidates. The two who get the most amount of votes will proceed. Thank you very much, everybody, for watching.
You're going to lose your position if I win.
This was the Lamb News Network.
You're done.
What? You're done. Gonna, ladies and gentlemen, yes, we'll see you.
You ain't done. Becoming governor, you fake.
Oh,
fuck.
Yes, I am.
Guess what?
And when I do, I'm gonna be gone.
I'm suing you for defamation, Johnny.
Good luck.
You'll be
good luck. Good luck.
Sue Johnny.
Good luck.
Ladies and gentlemen, do we have some beef here? Do we have some
you wanna go, Johnny?
How are you gonna take your position away from you?
You wanna fucking go? I'll fucking kick your ass.
Alright, yeah, fans, I don't think I want to get in any fights right now. I have a TV face. I have a face that I need to protect. Yeah, but I'll watch this. I hope Johnny goes down.
Johnny News!
Johnny News! This is a surprise match, to be sure. We were not expecting this. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready to throw down?
I'm gonna win.
You already got your own theme song covered. Do you want me to blast that over the radio for you?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. After I kick your ass, Johnny,
you're gonna keep going down. I'm gonna remove you from your position of power.
You got this.
You're gonna be gone. You're gonna be done. Finished.
Go, Julian!
Don't you see it? They're all working together. Dre and Spec, the Hingo Bottoms.
John Dre. You stop posting about Jack. You stop posting about me.
No promises.
And you stop making
no
lies,
promises.
Johnny.
No promises. Get head spin down, buddy.
Off of you.
Watch this move.
This one is gonna be best. 2 out of 3.
Watch this move.
2 of 3. Are you guys ready? Oh, that's impressive.
Oh, you think he's that good, huh?
Yeah.
You
wanna... Yeah, show me what you got.
Get ready!
Show me what you got.
2 of 3. On my mark.
Yeah, I just want to see Julian kick his ass real quick.
All right. Let's have some fun.
I'm living in that 21st century.
Show me what
you... Doing something meaningful.
Julian!
What the fuck?
Just because I was
beating your ass.
Hey,
take this outside the whip.
Don't say it. Hey, fat.
Cheating.
Not cheating.
Okay, I'm fine. Yeah, I'm good. What's going on?
How is he still up?
Oh, they're still going at it.
You're done, Johnny!
This man won't go down! It's rigged! It's rigged! He won't go down!
It's not rigged!
Yes! Julian, good work! Good work, Julian! Oh, you did it for all of us!
That was rigged!
Excuse me, sir.
I really hope nothing happens. Nothing bad happens to Julian Spector right now. I really hope nothing bad happens.
All right, folks, get ready.
You're doing good up till now. I was only using 5% of my power level.
I really hope nothing bad happens with you.
I'm in the 21st century. Doing something mean to it. Do it better to anybody.
Johnny.
Get up. Get up.
Julian already with the knockdown.
For the people. Corruption. Corruption. Beat his ass. Corruption. Corruption. Corruption.
Julian running around but missing his shot.
This guy doesn't go down. I hit him twice the amount of times.
I'm not
Julian,
doing
Julian.
Is what the chief does.
This is to my girlfriend. This is for
I
everyone. This
him
is
like
for the LAPD.
More times.
And this is for. Hey, shut up. Stay mad, cope.
Oh my God, he's about to kill
you. Shit talking to your news post, Johnny. That's all you can do.
Keep talking.
You're below me.
I'm removing
look
you from.
At you.
I'm removing
look at you.
You from power.
You're
keep
done.
Talking. You're losing your position of power.
All right, Julian.
You'll be held for trial, criminal.
But this isn't just my win. This is Jack
Lamb's
win also.
I can't beat a lizard person in hand-to-hand combat.
Go home!
It proves it.
Get the hell
I'll kick your ass, Julia, right now.
Everybody, thank you for coming. This concludes our debates today. Thank you for coming. And make sure you subscribe to the Lamb News Network.
Fuck you.
We did it.
Julian, that was beautiful. I'm going to post that all over the Lamb News Network. You did a great thing today. You avenged us. You avenged us.